Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. This tutorial shows you how to create a bootable installer for macOS 13 Ventura, the final release after 11 beta releases. You may ask, what are the advantages of creating a bootable USB macOS installer? A bootable USB installer allows you to install macOS on multiple Macs without having to re-download the installer each time you want to install macOS on your system. Bootable flash drives are useful, especially when you have a bad or slow internet connection. There are also situations when your Mac won't boot. In such a case, you can boot or start your Mac from your USB drive and use the built-in recovery tool to fix any issues you have with your system. Another significant advantage is that a bootable USB drive allows the user to perform a clean installation. When you perform a clean install, you will erase everything on your SSD or hard disk drive and install a fresh copy of macOS. You should always backup all your important files before erasing your disk. What are the advantages of a clean installation? A clean installation reduces many problems during and after the installation. It can improve your Mac's performance and speed. It can eliminate malware, viruses, and old hidden files. A clean installation removes unwanted programs and junk files from your computer. In some cases, it eliminates crashes and fixes incompatibility issues. Now that you are familiar with the advantages of having a bootable USB installer, let's learn how to create one for macOS 13 Ventura on your Mac. To create a bootable installer that you can use to install macOS onto multiple Macs, you need to connect a formatted USB flash drive, SSD, or hard disk drive to your Mac. If you haven't formatted your USB drive, I have a video on my channel showing you how to format and partition your drive. I leave the link in the description box underneath this video. Here is the USB hard disk drive I have. It has already been formatted and is ready to accept the macOS 13 Ventura installer. Your flash drive should be at least 16 gigabytes in size. I have divided my USB drive into three partitions for different purposes. Yours may have a single partition. It wouldn't make a difference. The process is the same. To install Ventura on your USB drive, launch the App Store application. It is in your applications folder. You can also launch it from the dock. Type macOS Ventura in the box. Press Enter on your keyboard. And click the Get button to download it. I have already downloaded Ventura installer, therefore the Get button is not available to me. You may see another pop-up window. Click download. To get the macOS installer, it downloads to your applications folder. Don't click on upgrade now. At this stage, you don't want to upgrade, but you want to download the installer. Once the download is complete, you will see the Ventura setup screen. Don't click on continue. Press Command plus Q on your keyboard, then click on quit or go to the installer menu and select quit install macOS. Connect your USB flash drive to your Mac. If you want to rename the drive, click on its name and change it to anything you want. For example, Ventura installer without space. Launch the terminal application. It is in your utilities folder inside the applications folder. Now you need to copy and paste this command. Into the terminal app. But before you do it, replace my volume with the name of your USB drive. In my case, I will replace my volume with Ventura installer without space. Then copy the command and paste it into the terminal app. Next, press Enter. Type your login password. And press Enter again. Your password is the one you use to log in to your Mac. It will not be displayed when you enter it in the terminal. Then type Y and press Enter to allow the terminal app to erase your volume. You may get a pop-up window asking you to allow terminal access to files stored on a removable volume. Click OK. The terminal will take about 30 minutes to create a bootable USB installer. I will leave this command in the description box under this video. Then you can use it to create your bootable installer. In my case, it took less than 10 minutes. You need to wait until you get the message install media now available at. It means your bootable USB installer is ready. Now you can install Ventura OS on your Mac using your bootable USB. For Intel Macs, connect your USB installer to your Mac if it's not connected. Restart and immediately press and hold down Option key. Release the Option key when you see bootable volumes. For the M1 or Silicon Macs, turn on your Mac and continue to press and hold down the power button until you see the Startup Options screen. Choose the drive that contains the bootable installer. I'll restart my Mac. Select your bootable installer In this case, install macOS Ventura and press Enter. Next, select your Wi-Fi name and enter your Wi-Fi password. Finally, click on Install macOS Ventura. If you don't have time to go through the installation process, select Restart or Shut Down from the Apple menu. If you are unfamiliar with the initial setup and are worried about mistakes, I have a tutorial on my channel that takes you through the setup process step by step. I'll put the link in the description box under this video if you want to watch it. I hope this video was helpful. If you learned something new from it, give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe if you want to receive notifications about future tutorials. Thank you for watching.